Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today I just want to show the different bows I have. I will not shoot with them. I will make a video on each bow where I shoot them at the target down here or another target depending on what I feel like. But I will just show them so you can see what I have. Alright, this is actually the first bow I ever had. Of course I have made stick bows as a kid, but before that, after that I mean, this was the first actual bow I ever had. And you can really see, I hope you can see it anyway on the camera, you can really see how much I have been using that. It's worn down right there to fit an arrow. I think I have had this for somewhere between 13 and 15 years. It have really seen better days, but it still works. It's a 20-pound bow, at least that was what I got it to when I checked it. The arrows for that bow is some crappy homemade arrows. I try to make them as good as possible, but the thing about them is I reuse both the feathers from broken arrows, and the field tips is also reused. So some of them is not fully straight, but they do actually shoot quite well, which you can see when I make the video on that bow. Then you have already seen my 30-pound longbow in my first video. So I don't really have much to say about that. I still don't remember what it's made out of, but it is one piece of wood, 30 pounds, a beautiful bow, and I'm very happy with it. The arrows for that is also homemade, but way better made. This one is worn down a bit in the feathers, but way better made, and with new parts, not reused. Then I have this one. This is a quite cool one. I only have two arrows for it right now, and it's made of the same as for the 30-pound. This is a 40-pound bow where I made this nice thing here for it to hold both arrows and the bow. I actually don't know if it's a longbow or a takedown bow. I actually don't know. I've been told it's a longbow, but I'm not sure. And then I have in the front here all of these things on it, but also room for some tools and especially the string. Okay, so let's try and string this bow. I really need to get a extra string for this because I don't think this string is too good, but it does work. And the way this works is that you take these out and just turn this so you can't turn that back, and you do that here as well. When you get these bows, if you buy one, it's made so you hold it like this and put the arrow on the left side, but you can take these off, turn them around, and then you have it on the right side, which I have done because I shoot on this side. I don't know if you can see this, but I'm just gonna string it here. Go. Now it's with the string on. It's a 40-pound, and it's quite a while ago I've been shooting with this, so it's a nice little bow to have for, yeah, well, if you're going somewhere. The thing about bows in Denmark is they are actually not under the laws of weapons. Of course you still have to follow some rules, but basically, you can take this with you, as far as I have been understanding the rules, but don't hang me up on it. So if you're going somewhere and you want to have your bow with you and you don't want to walk around with a big longbow, you can take one of these because it doesn't take up much space and it is actually quite lightweight. I don't know the exact weight, but it is a nice bow. And with this you can also have the tools you need if you want to switch the ends around, and also some extra stuff in there and arrows. The next one is this 55 pound compound bow. I think the lowest it can be set to is 30 pounds if I remember that right, but it is at 55 now. I really don't know what to say because I'm not really one that knows much about compound bows, but it is a great bow and I shoot with this. If I feel like shooting with a compound bow, I shoot with this one, not my other one that we get to in a moment, but that's because I think this is a little bit easier to use. 55 pounds is quite a lot when you're not used to it, but there is bows way stronger. I've seen people shoot with, I think the strongest I have seen is 240 pounds, but I'm not sure, I can't remember. That was not a compound bow, that was a longbow, I think. The arrows for this one, I don't know the brand by the way on this one. The arrows, I have a bunch of different ones, but it's just these carbon arrows. Both some rather expensive and some cheaper arrows, but all of them work. The last bow I have is this one. Nice old compound bow. It's a Browning. Hope you can see that. It's been used for hunting, this one. And what is it, 2, 4, 6 arrows I have for it, made of aluminum. It is not one of those modern sights or arrow shelves, but it's a nice bow and I will definitely be doing some shooting with this, but it's not one I use much, so it won't be seen much on the channel. I think mostly it will be the good old longbows, but I will do a video shooting with each of the bows. I don't have anything to measure with to tell how big the bows are and all that, but this is a 60 pound bow and it should be going to either 70 or 80. I think it only goes up to 70 pounds, but I've been told it goes for 80, but I'm not sure about it. So that's all my bows for now. I'm always looking for more. If I find one I like and it's not too expensive, I might buy it if the money is there. But I still have a bunch to shoot with. So I think that's all I wanted to do and say in this video. I just wanted to show you the bows, so you know what to expect a little bit anyway. And we will be shooting with them another day, or multiple days it will be. So thanks for watching.